everybody, welcome to another Microbiota tutorial. Yay! Guys, we are back.
Yes.
Ow.
That actually hurt my hand.
I am so sorry there was no video last week. Basically, I had recorded a video. I had a video planned. I recorded it. But then during the edit, I realized that I had no game audio, which isn't the end of the world. But then also whilst I was editing, I realized that I didn't actually like the video very much. You know when you think I could do this so much better, and I was just having one of those days with that video and I just deleted it. So that's why we had no video last week, and I am so sorry. Please forgive me. Anyway, what actually are we doing today? Well, today we are making a toggleable fireplace. Now, like usual, this build was suggested by you guys, but actually it was only suggested by one person. He literally comments on all my videos, so yeah, let's let him off. That, of course, is Bob Bobbery. So massive thanks to him for suggesting this build. So here is our toggleable fireplace. Now again, with this build, because it uses 1.16 features, I had just to use the 1.16 blocks, because just look at these. This crimson stem with the dark basalt, it just looks brilliant. Actually, saying basalt, is it basalt or basalt? Anyway, how does this build actually work? Well, of course, this is all activated with this button here. So at the moment, our fireplace is off. We have no fire. Press the button once. And now we have a red fireplace. And as you can see, those dispensers get hidden away. Press the button again. Now we have a blue fireplace, which just looks fantastic. And then press the button again, and the whole thing resets. No more fire. Now, you may imagine that this build has a lot of redstone at the back, which would make it a bit of a pain to put in your house. But you'd be wrong. Just look at that. This is the wall, and there is no redstone here. So you could literally put a wall next to this one, and it would be covering all the redstone from the back. How cool is that? I'm going to say the mumbo thing, aren't I? I can feel it coming. I'm going to say it. Guys, this build is very simple. But honestly, it really, really is. And as we go through the tutorial and I explain how this build works, you'll see it's super easy. Even the part with the button, with the three outcomes coming from one button, again, that is really easy. Honestly. Okay, so now you've seen the build and you've seen it working. Let's get on with this tutorial. So, for this amazing build, you are going to need 8 redstone, 60 pistons, 8 observers, 4 redstone pieces, 3 redstone torches, 13 redstone dust, 1 redstone block, 2 droppers, 2 comparators, 3 non-stackable blocks, 2 dispensers, 2 soul sword, 2 nova rack, 2 flint steel, 1 button, 29 blocks redstone to go, and high blocks needed for decoration. I don't recommend this, by the way. It really has a strain on the lungs. So don't do it. Okay, to start this build, like usual, we have to determine where we want our build to actually be. So where do you want your fireplace? Now, I want my fireplace. Okay, that actually genuinely scared me. Is that a thing with these new blocks? Do they just emit creepy sounds? Why is it? Why did it do that? Oh, where were we? Oh, dear. Okay, like I said, firstly, you need to determine where you want your build to actually be. So I want my fireplace to be here. Move these two blocks and place them down, okay? So I want my fire to go on these two blocks, and my fireplace to go around here. So after you have that in place, you want to break out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 blocks from the left and 5 from the right. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 3 from the front. 1, 2, 3 and then we can remove these blocks here. Okay, like that. And also we can remove the blocks underneath your wall. So all of these ones here. And then the ones behind. Okay, so you should have a 6. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Perfect. By 12 wide hole. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Brilliant. But of course, this is only one deep, and you can't fit much redstone in this little area. So you need to dig this out 4 more times. This hole needs to be 5 deep. Okay, like that. So it's 6 long, 12 wide, by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 deep. So the first part we're going to work on is the block swapper. Now, of course, we can't see any of the redstone on top. We need these blocks to firstly retract and then to be swapped over. So first of all, we need to find a way to retract the blocks. So how do we do that? Well, first of all, we'll place two decoration blocks in front like this. One and two. I'm using gilded blackstone, but you can use whatever you like. Then place a sticky piston off the right of these two blocks. On the face of our sticky piston, place a redstone block, a temporary block down, and two to the right. Remove this block and dust on both, which should turn on. Then we want to grab two sticky pistons and place them off the side of these two blocks here. One going up into that soul soil, and another one here going up toward that soul soil. Then on top of this sticky piston, place a decoration block. I'm going to be using chiseled polished blackstone, and place your button on it. Then place a temporary block here, and another one like that on here, and you don't need to place a button. It's completely up to you. But basically now, when I press this button, this sticky piston will obviously extend, moving this redstone block down to here, turning off this dust, unpowering these blocks, meaning that these pistons will retract their blocks. So the soul soil will go down to here, and then when that button comes back out, when it's finished, finished its pulse, then the sticky piston will obviously retract, moving the dust back to here, extending our pistons, like this. Perfect. Now we need to work on block swapper. Okay, so when we press this button once, we want this soul sand to go down, and then some neverrack to be pushed over, and then pushed up. Okay, now that is extremely simple. So first you place a block here, and then a dropper facing toward the right. Place another block out, remove this one, and then have another dropper going toward this one here, like this. Make sure that these two are droppers and not dispensers, okay? Then place another block out like this, remove this one, one here and one down, remove these two, and have a comparator coming away from this dropper, like that. Then have a sticky piston facing toward the back off the side of this block, and an observer with a dot facing toward the sky here, off the face of that sticky piston. On top of the sticky piston, place a block. Now we want to place three blocks like this, one, two, and three. Two on top of the ends, one and two, and remove these ones, one and two. Now coming away from this block toward this one, we need a repeater on two tick delay. So place a repeater down and press it once. Then grab some pistons, some regular pistons, and place them like this, one and two, and then two pieces of neverrack like this, one and two. Now in this dropper here, in the left one, we want three non-stackable items. So that could be a wooden sword, a wooden shovel, a wooden pickaxe, something like that. So I'm just going to use these very cheap swords, which I found lying about. So just make sure you have three of them. Okay? So now, when I press this button, like we said, this sticky piston will extend, obviously, moving this redstone block down to here. Now when that happens, when that redstone block comes in contact with this dropper, it's going to power this dropper, moving one of these swords over to here. When this dropper gets a sword inside it, this comparator will turn on because it will recognize that, powering this block, which will power this sticky piston, extending the sticky piston, moving that observer to here. When that observer has detected that it's moved, it will give a pulse, pulsing into this block, moving this piston and this neverrack one to the left. Two ticks later, this repeater will turn on, powering this block, which will then power this piston, which will then have moved to here, moving those two neverrack over to here. Now, of course, it can push it over because these sticky pistons would have retracted because that redstone block would not be powering this dust. It sounds quite complicated, but when you see it happening, it really is very simple. Like this. Okay, so that's the first block swapper all done. How about the second? So when we press the button another time, now we want this neverrack to go down, the soul sand to move, not soul sand, the soul soil to move over and then extend. So how do we do that? Well, place a block here and one down, remove this block, and have a comparator coming away from this dropper, which should turn on. Then three blocks out, one, two, and three, with dust on each one. You'll see this dust is connecting. Now we do not want that, so place a regular block on top. You'll see this dust is now a darker red. That's basically because this is a lower signal strength than that. Now come to the end of this block and place a torch. Then place a sticky piston off the end like that, going toward the back. All right? Then place an observer on the face of that sticky piston facing upward, so the dot going toward the sky. Three blocks out like this, one, two, three, one here and one up. Remove these two, and then you guessed it, we want to place a repeater coming away from this block toward this one on two ticks. So place it down and press it once. Oh yeah, sorry, I forgot. Add two pistons like this, one and two. So when I press this button for the second time, like we said, this block will power, powering this piston, moving this redstone block down to here. When this dropper gets in contact with this redstone block, it's going to pulse, it's going to power. When it powers, now a second sword will move over to here. So now this dropper will have two swords, and this one will only have one. This circuit will not be affected by that happening because this comparator is already on. But when this dropper goes down to one sword, this comparator will realize that and it will drop its signal strength down to two. One sword or one non-stackable item gives a signal strength of two. So when it gets powered, one sword will go into there, but this will only have one of them, and this comparator will only give a signal strength of two. So that means this dust here will turn off. When that dust turns off, that block will unpower, allowing this torch to power, which will power the sticky piston, extending it. So that observer will go underneath this block here, which will pulse into this block, extending this piston, moving this piston and the two soul soil over to the right one block. At the same time, it will power this repeater, and after two ticks, it will give its power into this block, which will then extend this piston, which by that time has moved to here, moving the soul soil another one to the right. And then those pistons will extend again. Again, it can sound quite confusing, but watching it happen is really, really simple. Like that. You can see that dust is off, but that one is still on. Okay, so now we have our two block droppers in place. Now, on the third time we press the block, we want our soul sand to go down, then back up, because that will destroy the fire. But at the same time, we want this counter to reset. So of course, when we extend this piston, that redstone block moves down to here, moving that last sword over to the right. Now, we don't want it over to the right. We want all three swords to be over to the left. So how do we do that? Well, we come to our second block here, and we place a torch out the back, which should turn off because that dust is on. Then a sticky piston like that going toward the left. Then grab an observer and place it going toward that sticky piston, so the face facing outward. Then place a temporary block here and another observer here and remove this block. So you can see these two faces are having a staring competition. Who's going to win? I don't know. Then on the dot... Please, with the sound effects, can you stop? Oh, that one didn't scare me so much. I'm all right. Right, in front of that dot, place a block. Then come through here. And on that block, have a torch, which should turn on. And then a block on top. Now, as you probably just heard there, when I placed that block on top, and the same when you did it, you probably heard this piston retract. So now the system thinks we want to move the soul soil over, but of course we've already moved it over. So just press it one more time, like that, and now we'll be back with two swords in this side and one in this side. So now when I press this button again, when this redstone block moves to here, that last sword will go into here, so this will have three inside, this will have zero, this comparator will then turn off because there's nothing to compare, so this dust will obviously turn off, allowing this torch to turn on, extending this piston, moving this observer to here. When that observer moves to here, that will create an observer clock. So there's basically pulses we're going back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, which will keep powering and unpowering this block, which will keep on unpowering and powering this torch, which will keep on unpowering and powering this block, which again will keep unpowering and powering this dropper. Whew, that was a mouthful. But of course, as soon as one of these swords make its way back into this dropper, that dust will turn back on, again turning off our clock. But by the time it's done that, all three of these swords will have made its way into this dropper, like this. You see that? One sword means that side, two swords moving over is this side, and then three swords, they drain from here and go into here. Okay, so that's the main bulk of the redstone all done, the block swapper and the funny counter thing. But you may have noticed that this fireplace is not yet on fire. So like we just said, now we need to work on the fire lighting system. So when do we actually want the fire to light? Well, we want it to fire when this Neverack first moves over. So we want that to be on fire. We also want this Soul Soil to be on fire, but then on the third press, we don't want it to be on fire. So how do we do that? Well, we go around the back and firstly place two regular pistons off the side of these piston arms. So that's one here and one here. So they're one above these ones, as you can see. Now grab two dispensers and place them on top of these pistons facing toward our Soul Soil. So one here and one here. Make sure that these two are dispensers and not droppers. Then count up one, two decoration blocks above our dispenser. That's one, two. Then remove the top two and remove these two. And then place two regular pistons like this. One and two. So you can kind of see how this is going to work now. So when I press the button, of course, the Neverack is going to be pushed over and then up. Then we want these pistons to extend, moving this whole stack up. So those dispensers will be here. So those dispensers will be here. Then they need to fire, which will obviously light our fire. And then we want a pulse to go into these pistons to move that stack down again to hide our dispensers. Right, to make that happen, firstly, come down here and place three blocks like this. One, two, and three. One up in the middle and remove the block underneath. On this block, have some dust. And coming away from this block on this one, have a repeater on four tick delay. So place it down and press it three times. Once, twice, and thrice. Then place a block here. One up, three along, and one up here. Remove this block, and dust all along. One, two, three, four. Then we can do something similar on this side. So place three blocks like this. One up in the middle. Move the one underneath, dust here, and a repeater here on four tick delay. So now, when this block swapper activates, or this block swapper activates, this dust will be activated. Why? Well, because remember, the observer is going to move underneath this block, which will power this dust, which is obviously going to power the block. This repeater, after four ticks, will power, powering this block, powering this dust, powering this dust, powering this dust. And it's also going to power this dust, which extends our pistons, moving these dispensers up to here. And it's the same on this side. Now that we've got that, now we want to remove these three blocks here. One, two, three. And these three blocks on this side. One, two, three. Because now after these have been moved up, we need to power the dispensers. To do that, we grab an observer and place it on top of that dust and a block. And the same on this side. And that's it. So when those dispensers move up to here, of course, this dust will be activated. Those observers will detect that dust being activated, powering these blocks for a very brief second. And by the time the power has moved up from here to here, those dispensers will be up here, which obviously will power them. Now, the last thing, like we said, we've got to move the whole stack down. And we do that by placing two bits of dust and two observers. And that's it. So after these blocks have been powered, powering our dispensers, this dust will obviously activate. These observers will detect that, powering these blocks on top, moving our stack down. Like this. You see there? But of course, on our third button press, these blocks here are not going to get powered, so this will not activate. Perfect. So now in these two dispensers, we can place in our flint and steel. So now when we press this button once, we'll have our red flame. When we press the button again, we'll have our blue flame. And then when we press the button on the third time, we have no flame. So now we can definitely say that this fireplace is lit. I'm so, so sorry that you had to hear that. So of course, all that is left to do is to decorate. So I just like to place some blocks like this. Some blocks up like that, some more blocks, slabs like that on top of these two. Then make sure you cover up these pistons. So I'm going to place stairs up like that, and make sure you cover this as well. I'm going to place stairs going this way. Then some more blocks like this, and more like that. There we are, and now we can cover up our redstone with our flooring. And then I like just to place in some pillars as well to make it look a little bit more grand. So now a quick final test with everything in place. Press the button once, red flame. Perfect. Press the button again, blue flame. And press the button a final time, no flame. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. If you did like this video or like this design, please give us a like. And if you really loved it, make sure you subscribe with that wonderful subscribe button for more awesome content. Anyway, I'll catch you guys next one, and I'll see you later. Bye!